Ladies and gentlemen, welcome the f- back. I don't even know what we're calling it. Don't have a name yet. Still got to figure that part out. This is the epitome. We've reached the mountaintop of food and drink news. This is your weekly roundup, your one-stop shop, your go-to. Nobody else is doing it. No one else is doing it. Nobody's doing it like I am, at least. I don't know of anybody who's doing it. Is anyone actually doing it? I don't think so. We're covering the latest and greatest in the world of food and drink, junk food, new snack foods, new fast food items, everything. We're covering it, all of it. Like, who wants to watch CNN, NBC? Nobody wants to watch that Fox News. Listen to politicians debate about nothing. People really want to listen to, like, just news about food. I've came up with the greatest idea ever in the history of time, potentially. And I'm your host, if you haven't figured that out. We got a lot of to cover. It's gonna get crazy. I got a drink. Got a little, just being real extra today with the dehydrated blood orange for no reason at all other than to make it look pretty. Little Campari's Saint Germain cocktail. Why not? There's a little bourbon in there. Oh my God. You got one of these? Do one of these? Should we do this? This is an herbal blend. Very nice herbal blend of, you know, thyme and rosemary, different aromatic herbs. Nothing else inside of this. It's an herbal cigarette, if you will. I need some help on the name, by the way. I gotta figure out like a great name for this segment, podcast, show, thing, whatever the f*** this is. I don't know what it is because it's like it's still being born. It's being conceived. I haven't fully like come to terms on what exactly it is, other than food and drink news. But like a great name, we need a great name to go along with this. Whatever day you're watching this on, happy whatever day it is for you. Hope you're having a great day. Man, so many things, so many items since the last roundup, the last thing to cover. I mean, we got a lot to get through. We're gonna plow through it. Where to begin? You guys ready for this? Watch this. Watch what's gonna happen right now. It's gonna be crazy. Ready for this little transition? Bam. Is that not beautiful? One more time. Run it back real quick. I like that. That's nice, right? It's kind of cool. Shout out OBS. That's a delicious herbal cigarette. Really just delicious flavor and aroma of rosemary and thyme and shit like that. Speaking of which, we got to look it up real quick. I was watching this old video, old movie. Shit, what's it called? It's going to make sense in a second when I play the song. But I was just the rosemary and thyme, and it just like, I just had a brain blast. I was watching The Graduate, awesome movie from like 76 or 67? I think it's 76. Dustin Hoffman, Rosemary, and there's this one song in this scene that they just play for like 10, it's like a 10 minute fucking scene, Rosemary and Thyme, the song with these lyrics, and they just keep playing the lyrics are just, the whole song is just repeating the same shit. It's Rosemary and Thyme. You'll see in a second. It's something. Parsley, sage, rosemary and thyme. We gotta play this. Simon and Garfunkel. Is this the song? Fucking love this song. I don't know why. I love that movie, but this song is just a trip. It's 60s, baby. It's coming.
Are you going to Scarborough Fair? Parsley, sage, rosemary.
Dude, that's the shit you listen to when you're tripping on acid or you're doing some shrooms or something. That's what you want to listen to. You want to listen to Simon and Garfunkel, Scarborough Fair, the Scarborough Fair song, where they just say parsley, rosemary, sage and thyme, or however, whatever order it goes in. Anyways, let's get into the food news. That's just, I had to get that off my chest. Shit. Food and drink. Just so you know, what day is it? It's the 20th. So this came out on the 15th, I think. McDonald's, the Shamrock Shake comes back every year around St. Patty's Day. It's back. I don't know. I'm not a fan of it. I don't think I've ever had it. I can't really say I'm not a fan of it if I've never had it, but it's a mint milkshake. I don't get milk. Like, but who wants to have a mint milkshake? I can't even fucking say it because it's disgusting. It doesn't even deserve to be spoken into existence. Who wants to have a mint milkshake? Like peppermint ice cream makes no fucking sense to me. It's like minty creaminess in your mouth that just sounds, it doesn't sound nice. It doesn't sound good. I don't like that. I don't understand it. I don't understand mint desserts. Do people like mint desserts? Do you like mint desserts? Why do people like mint desserts? Why are they a thing? Like, when I think dessert, I think like chocolate, caramel, like delicious fucking just like desserty flavor things. I don't think, oh, I want mint. Yeah, I'll take some mint, a scoop of mint ice cream. And also, why the fuck, why is like Scottish, Irish people, St. Paddy's Day? What is that? Scottish? Is it Irish? It's Irish, right? I would imagine it's Irish. Why is mint the flavor of the Shamrock Shake? Now that I'm thinking about it, why did they could have gone any fucking direction. They obviously, it's going to be green. That makes sense, right? The shake is green. Why does it have to be mint flavored? You could have gone so many different ways with the flavor of green. Mint is not like the first thing I want to taste in a dessert. It's probably like the last thing. I don't get it, but it is back. And I think it stops being sold on St. Paddy's Day. When St. Paddy's Day, the 13th. Is my mic on right now? Okay, my mic's on. Great. I was about to lose my shit. 800 calories for a large, FYI. St. Pat, what is it, the 13th? St. Paddy's Day, March, it's the 17th. So it's here. It's going to be here for like another month, basically. If you want to go grab it, you can go grab the Shamrock Shake. I won't be grabbing one because for obvious reasons that were clearly stated in the last 2 minutes. Make it your lucky day with the shake that started it all. Is it the shake that started it all? Is that the original shake of McDonald's? It's definitely fucking not. They definitely started with vanilla flavored milkshake. So why does it say, make it your lucky day with the shake that started it all? Started what all? I don't even know what that means. Okay, McDonald's. No, I'm not going to, definitely not allowing my location with you. Fuck you, McDonald's. Is made with a creamy vanilla soft serve blended with Shamrock Shake syrup. It's a registered trademark of McDonald's, Shamrock Shake. Whatever the fuck that means. Just say mint syrup. It's just a mint syrup. Shamrock Shake syrup. Okay. Topped with delicious whipped topping. Oh, God. What does that mean? What's in their whipped topping? Just say whipped cream if it's whipped cream, which clearly means it's not actually whipped cream, which means it's like a bioengineered fucking fake whipped topping. It's not even... It's probably not even, there's probably no dairy in there. It's like a fake artificial McDonald's. So that's some shit McDonald's would do. It's available in small, medium, and large. No shit. I would imagine the fuck so. What other sizes is it coming in? It's coming in a venti. Get a Shamrock Shake or the Oreo Shamrock McFlurry. You know what? I could fuck around with that. That doesn't sound bad. I might do that. I might do it. Oreo Shamrock McFlurry. That sounds kind of good. Before they're gone, they're 800 calories in a large. Yeah, we got that part. Thank you. Anyways, it's here if you want it. Not crazy about the whole mint thing. Moving on. We got a lot of items to get through. Shit. So I don't want to spend like, you know, 20 minutes on the Shamrock McFlurry. It's a good fucking cocktail. My God. Ooh. 2 ounces of bourbon. With a rye heavy Old Granddad 114 bourbon. 1 ounce of Campari. An ounce of Saint Germain and a dash of orange bitters. Pretty good cocktail. A little bit too sweet for my taste. I probably would have gone 2 ounces of bourbon, 3/4 ounce of the Campari, and 3/4 ounce of Saint Germain. I think would be fucking perfect. But flavor wise, I really like it. That's a good cocktail. I would recommend it if you like bourbon, if you like Campari, sweet Saint Germain, any of the above. Mix them all up. You got a magical, delicious, tasty cocktail. And then make sure you throw an unnecessary dehydrated blood orange on there just to be fucking extra. Moving the fuck on. This one is, man, I've like mixed emotions about this. I'm going to explain in a second. Hold on. I need to get some nicotine in my blood system, my blood stream. What? Blood vessels? Blood vessels. That's definitely the right way to say it. It's not blood. Is it bloodstream or blood? Are blood vessels the same thing as your bloodstream? I don't know. So this one I'm torn on. I fucking love truffles, which is ironic because I'm not a big mushroom fan. I'm finally at the age of 26 beginning to like mushrooms. Like, I've been buying shiitake mushrooms, which I think are actually kind of delicious. It just took me a long, long time. Like, I've never, something about the texture of mushrooms that I don't like. They're kind of rubbery. They're growing on me. I'm starting to like mushrooms, and especially because I've been buying a whole, like, different varieties of mushrooms. Shiitake mushrooms are fucking delicious. They're like a buttery, kind of like meaty, beefy, like kind of in a good way, flavor wise. And I don't know. Shiitake mushrooms are pretty good. And it's ironic because truffles, I fucking love truffles. Like, if you've never had truffles before, even if you end up not liking it, it's something you gotta try. And while I haven't eaten a single piece of truffle, like real truffle, I've had all types of truffle flavored things. I'm hoarding in my closet over there, like 5 bottles of the truffle powder from Trader Joe's, which is like the greatest thing. Only comes out in November. They're like $5 a pop. They're this big. It's so fucking good. I can't even describe it. Truffle is like its own flavor. Like truffle anything is like, you can't compare it to anything. It's literally its own thing, but I feel like it's like a divisive thing. Like you either love it or you hate truffles. Anything truffle flavored honey, truffle powder, truffle butter, truffle salt, truffle anything. Like I'm game. I'm with it 1,000%. So there's this brand Truff. I've gotten their hot sauce before. I've tried their hot sauce. Their hot sauce is banging. It's a little bit too spicy for me, so I use it sparingly. But their truffle hot sauce is, again, it's delicious. So for a long time, they only had their truffle hot sauces. They have 3 different versions. And then recently, they started pumping out these new products. They have a truffle pasta sauce, 2 of them. 2 truffle pasta sauces, which I haven't tried. And then they have this new truffle mayo. So normally, I would be like, hell yeah, truffle mayo. Let me get some. I'm going to order it right now. The thing with truffles is if you're completely uneducated on truffles, which not a big deal. Like I don't expect you to be a truffle fucking expert if you're watching this video, and neither am I. But if you know anything about truffles, you know that they're extremely expensive. And it's like, think of it like gold. Like the only reason gold is so valuable is because of its scarcity, right? Truffles, they use like fucking truffle sniffing dogs and shit to find the truffles. It's like a whole process. They grow like in the dirt, in the ground. It's not like you could just have, I mean, there's like truffle farms, but that takes, I don't know, a lot of resources and money and time, I would imagine. So it's not like they can just harvest and grow truffles like they can corn, essentially. So they're expensive, long story short. Like real quick, let's go to fucking Amazon. Like if I were to go buy truffles, I definitely wouldn't buy them off Amazon, but Amazon was pumping me, fucking feeding me ads on Facebook trying to sell me truffles because they dude, technology, man, it's fucked up. Like my phone knows that I like truffles, and they were giving me ads on Amazon to like, hey, do you want to go buy some truffles on Amazon right now? And out of curiosity, I clicked on it naturally. And then I saw the price and I was like, why did I just, tipsy shit right now. I just searched Amazon in Amazon. That's Greek fucking content. Why did I do that? We're looking for truffles. Wait, why is that the first thing that pops up when you search Amazon? It comes up with bikini panties, Amazon essential panties. That's great. That's fucking so good. Truffles. So if you want to go buy truffles, like legitimate, yeah, fresh and wild, whole black winter Perigord truffles, European. Why is the longest fucking title ever. Let's see. We'll just call it in the middle, 2 ounces of truffles, which is like probably like enough to fit like right there. Like it's like the size of your thumb, is $129. Just, I want to give you, you know, perspective. Anyways, going back to the truff mayo, why did I not order this? It's 25 fucking bucks. I'm sorry. I love the brand. Their branding's fucking gorgeous. I love their packaging. I love the way they set up their social media and all the content they push out and the photography and the videos that they do. I'm really big in the branding. The branding is just fucking gorgeous. It's simple, clean. But who the fuck is paying $25 for truffle mayonnaise? I'm sorry. Let's be honest. There's no fucking way it costs them more than $7 to manufacture that. There's no way. It probably costs them like $2.50 to make that jar. If that. It's for a 2-pack. So, you know what? It's not horrible for a 2-pack. I thought that was for one single jar. I'm now realizing, in all honesty, that that's for a 2-pack. But $25 fucking? Nah. I can't justify it. I love truffles. Love mayonnaise. Who doesn't love mayonnaise? But $25. Bro, it's fucking mayo. I could go get Hellman's at Kroger, Stop and Shop, any supermarket across the US for like, I could get the super poor fucking mayonnaise for like $1.99 for an 8-ounce jar, if that. Y'all are charging $25 for truffle infused mayo? No. I'm sure it's delicious. I want to try it. I'm not spending $25 on mayo. That's ludicrous. Side note, shout out the giant fucking two pimples on my forehead. Do you see these? There's two of them. There was only one this morning. Now there's a second one. Giant fucking pimples. I look like I'm 16 out here. Like I just hit puberty. Great. Featured in Today, Good Morning America, Rolling Stones, Forbes, blah, 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 blah. Let's look at the ingredients just for shits and giggles. I want to see if they're actually using real truffle. Because if they're not using real truffle, then we have a major fucking problem. Sunflower oil, first ingredient. Egg yolks, water, blah, blah, blah. Black truffle oil concentrate. Organic lemon juice, black truffle. Okay, so there's real black. Okay. There's real black truffle in there. That's cool. Because some of these fucking truffle products are using like synthetic fake truffle perfume, like not real truffles, just to make it just like mimic the flavor and taste of truffles. So they are using real truffles. I'll give them that. I do recommend the hot sauce. Like if you like spicy, I don't like super spicy. I could handle their hot sauce. Like I said, I use it sparingly, but damn man, $25. While we're on the site, let's check out that they got the new pasta sauce. How much is that? $30. I mean, the hot sauce alone is like $15, I think. It's $17.98. That's fuck, man. That's crazy. $18 for hot sauce. I've actually never bought it. Like I only had people gift it to me because I would never spend that much money on hot sauce. So if you like truffles, check them out if you want. Anyways, moving the fuck on. We spent like 17 minutes on truffles. Too much. Taco Bell. Check it out. Taco Bell seasoning. It's official. It's a real thing right now. Apparently, according to my Instagram, Taco Bell has released seasoning packets. I thought that was relevant information for this video. Oh my God, it's on Amazon and on Walmart. A single pack. Who the fuck's buying a single pack? $1.67, not even a dollar, 67 cents for original taco seasoning mix. What's in the seasoning mix? There's got to be MSG in it. I'll bet money there's MSG. No MSG. Interesting. Wheat flour. Why is wheat flour the first ingredient for a seasoning mix? That's weird. Salt, garlic, chili peppers, maltodextrin, spice, onions. What the fuck is maltodextrin? I see that all the time. Maltodextrin. Dextrin? Dextrin? Dextorin? Maltodextrin is a... Jesus Christ. Maltodextrin is a polysaccharide that is used as a food additive. What the fuck does that mean? A food additive, clearly. What the fuck does it do? It's produced from vegetable starch by partial hydrolysis and is usually found as a white hydroscopic spray dried powder. It's just a bunch of big words that aren't explaining what the fuck it is. Maltodextrin is easily digestible, being absorbed as rapidly as glucose. It may be either moderately sweet or almost flavorless. So it serves no purpose. It's flavorless. What does it do? I don't understand. It just, every article just keeps saying it's a food additive. For what? For what, motherfucker? It's commonly used in the production of soft drinks and candy. Food uses, okay? Wikipedia, please come the fuck through right now. Okay, so here we go. It's used to improve the mouthfeel of food and beverage products. Interesting. That's actually pretty fucking interesting. So it adds to the mouthfeel. That's its sole purpose. I'm not going to go into a whole health thing on whether it's good or bad for you. I can't do that right now. That'll be like a 30-minute segment that I'm not prepared for. I'm assuming there's sugar in this. Let's not get super in-depth with it. I feel like I'm more interested in nutrition facts than most people. So anyways, Taco Bell has their new seasonings. How many different flavors are there? Okay, just original. Oh, great. You can get 24 Taco Bell seasoning packets for $19. Who the fuck... I'm sorry. Is anyone actually spending $19 on a 24-pack of Taco Bell seasoning mixes? Not me. Why is it $19? That's fucking... That's like an insult to my intelligence. People are actually that fucking dumb to go spend $19 on Taco Bell seasoning packets. And if you're one of those people, I'm sorry. But that's just fucking dumb. That's too much money. You could make those seasoning packets at home. Go buy all the individual shit. You'll make a whole fucking, enough to fill this desk of Taco Bell homemade seasoning for like a fraction of the cost. Ridiculous. I can't do it. I can't justify it. Too much. Is there only one seasoning flavor? Oh my God. Maybe this isn't new. Is this new? I feel like this, I just saw this on my Instagram. Maybe it's not a new thing. Maybe this has been around forever. In which case, we just wasted like 4 minutes on an unnecessary segment. I can't even fucking speak today. It's crazy. Is it the alcohol or is it my rosemary, sage, parsley, and thyme cigarette? I don't know. Moving the fuck on, shall we? Bam, sis. Get ready, people. Starburst yogurt is hitting shelves. Matter of fact, it's not hitting shelves. It has hit shelves. It's on shelves because I actually saw it the other day. I didn't buy it, but Starburst and what is it? Yoplait? Yeah, they teamed up with Yoplait. Yoplait and Starburst, they made a fucking baby. We have Starburst yogurt now. On paper, it sounds fucking great. Sounds like a perfect marriage, like a beautiful combination. Probably shouldn't be blowing parsley smoke onto the mic. Probably not good for the mic. Maybe it sounds great. Like fruit and yogurt, obviously they go together well. The question is it actually good? There's only one way to find out. So if you've had the Starburst Yoplait yogurt and you liked it or didn't like it, let me know in the fucking comments. Drop a comment right now. Let me know what you thought of it. Is it worth picking up? Because I am intrigued. I mean, who doesn't love Starburst, especially like the strawberry one? Strawberry is the best one. The orange and the fucking yellow, they can go fuck themselves. I don't even know what they are. They're like the lemon and orange. Ew. Nobody wants that. I don't know why, now that I think about it, like all these gummy candies, like I think of every single gummy candy, they always have like lemon, lime, orange. Why the fuck do those exist? All people really want is strawberry. Maybe cherry. I could fuck around with the cherry. Like the red Starburst is cool, but strawberry is just, strawberry is king and queen. That's the best. That's the number one. That's the greatest. That's what the fucking people want. So just stop making orange and lime and citrus flavored candies. We don't need that. Strawberry from here on out. That's all that matters. Yeah, I kind of wish I had grabbed it. It sounds really good. Starburst fucking yogurt. It's kind of genius. This should have been a thing like 10 years ago. Why is this just becoming a thing? Oh, fuck. This isn't new news. I keep, I got to stop trusting Instagram because I saw this on Instagram and they were like, oh, brand new food item, Starburst and Yoplait collab. Not fucking true because I'm reading an article by Samantha Cabuto on Today News, today.com from December 6, 2019. It's like 2 fucking years ago. That's not like 2 years ago. What am I saying? That's like 15 months ago. That's still a long time. That's over a year ago. Not really new. Whoever gave me false information on Instagram, now I'm upset. Now I don't trust you. Now I can't. Now I have to unfollow your page. Don't worry. What is this saying? Don't worry, comma, pink, aka strawberry, is one of the flavors. Okay. In a departure from the usual yogurt flavors like strawberry or even key lime pie, Yoplait just released 4 new Starburst flavors. Cherry, lemon, orange, and strawberry. Super. Super duper. You know what? Now I'm thinking about it. Maybe when this article came out, it was only like a regional thing. It wasn't a national thing. Maybe that's why my Instagram is telling me that it's a new food item because it went like nationwide. I might need to pick some up. Should I pick some up? I think I should grab it next time I see it. Next up, we got like 6 more. This is a big one. This is a big one, folks. Man, I gotta get like situated for this one. I gotta get comfy, nice and cozy. Let's talk about Aunt Jemima. When I think like America, there's like 10 things that pop in my mind. Things like baseball, I think apple pie, and then I think Aunt Jemima. I think like maple syrup, fucking pancakes. Obviously, Aunt Jemima, it's not like real maple syrup, not like the real deal, like you're extracting the maple syrup from the maple trees in Vermont. But, I mean, you can't go wrong with Aunt Jemima. You fucking can't. It's American. Aunt Jemima syrup, delicious. So not supposedly, but 9 months ago, you know, it's been a crazy year. This is a sensitive topic, so I don't want to press buttons, but like the Aunt Jemima company, whoever owns Aunt Jemima was like, we're changing that. We're dropping Aunt Jemima. Aunt Jemima's fucking gone. We're going to rebrand it. We're going to take Aunt Jemima off the thing, off the packaging. Supposedly it's like a whole subservient, you know, like master slave fucking thing that like, that's who Aunt Jemima was portraying, was like the happy go lucky, big smile on her face, black slave woman servant. So I get it, but it's just like, as my friend Tim would say, by them doing this, them saying, oh, we're gonna take her off the packaging, it's like drawing attention to it and making it a big deal. When it was, it really a big deal? Like were people rioting over the fact that Aunt Jemima was on the packaging? I don't think so. To me it was fucking news. I'm like, when I first heard about it, I'm like, they're taking Aunt Jemima off the packaging? Why? Why do we need to say it's like a happy black woman? All my friends are black or Hispanic. So just for the fucking record, I just don't get it. Why do we need to take Aunt Jemima off the packaging? Feels like it's unnecessary. And even worse, what's the new name for Aunt Jemima? They replaced Aunt Jemima with the Pearl Milling Company. the Pearl Milling Company? Why the fuck is it the Pearl Milling Company? When you think maple syrup, do you think, oh, the Pearl Milling Company? No, I don't think of pearls. I don't think of milling. I don't even know what milling is. What is milling? That doesn't make me think maple syrup at all. Not in the slightest. What is milling? What does that mean? Designed to cut or shape metal using a rotating tool. Moving around in a confused mass. That's what milling is. Okay. You dropped Aunt Jemima, like one of the most American iconic things in the history of America. Delicious maple syrup, fake high fructose corn syrup, maple flavored syrupy goodness. You just fucking drown. Nice. You got like a fat stack fucking pancakes. Nice dollop of butter, not even a dollop, like more than a dollop, like an ice cream spoon, ice cream scoop worth of butter, and you fucking drown it in some Aunt Jemima, and y'all had to fucking drop it because apparently people were getting upset. Have we reached that point and people are getting upset over a black woman? On if anything, to me, it's like, oh, we're like putting the black woman up on a pedestal. She's the face of Aunt Jemima, of maple syrup, a fake maple syrup, and we're just, no, we can't have that. We got to replace it with the Pearl Milling Company. That's all I'm going to say on that, because I could just go on and on and on fucking on, just on a rant about this ridiculous, what I, in my personal opinion, is unnecessary rebrand of the Aunt Jemima syrup. Should we take a look at the new packaging? It looks like fucking shit. It looks like this is the exact same thing, but you just took Aunt Jemima's name and you replaced it with the Pearl Milling Company and removed Aunt Jemima's beautiful black face. You just took it off unnecessarily. Look at this. This is infuriating. I'm upset now. I don't like this. I'm literally upset. I downloaded this little thing. Should we do a zoom on this? Does it work? Oh, fuck. Look at that. Can you see that? You see that zoom? Little zoom, like Chrome, Google Chrome application. Zoom in. Retired. New Pearl Milling Company. Fucking dumbest name in history. Moving on. I can't. I gotta move on. I can't do it anymore. I don't even know what's next. Ooh, saw this on Instagram. I don't know how new this is. Before I go on a whole tangent about this being like a brand new food item, let's actually confirm that this is new. If you've ever had Biscoff, I mean, fuck. If you haven't, this is a food and drink show. You wouldn't be watching the show if you didn't know what Biscoff was. But if you don't, for some ridiculous reason that I can't even wrap my head around. Biscoff is like this delicious little cookie from like France or something. Every time I fly, well, I haven't flown in like 2 years now for obvious reasons. Fucking coronavirus. Thank you very the fuck much. When I used to fly, I would fly Delta. And on Delta, they have Biscoff cookies. You know, they bring you a little drink, a little snack. They give you Biscoff cookies. I have like a fucking collection in my closet. Don't tell anyone. This is like top secret shit. And I've been hoarding Biscoff cookies that I, you know, got on the plane on Delta flights. On my many Delta flights, I would just, you know, hey, you know, have like an extra cookie, or like two extra cookies. And they, oh, absolutely. They just give me a fucking handful of cookies. So like in my closet, in a little Ziploc bag in the fucking corner, is just probably like 40 Biscoff cookies, give or take 40 Biscoff little packaged, individual wrapped, delicious Biscoff cookies in my closet right now, because they're delicious. Fucking love them. It was the first time I ever had a Biscoff cookie on the fucking plane, 3,000 feet in the air, however many, 30,000, is it 3,000 or like 30,000 feet in the air. They have a Biscoff cookie ice cream now. Fucking freaking out. Supposedly, it's a Target exclusive item. I went to Target, at least my local Target. I couldn't find it, but supposedly, it's like you can only get it at Target. So if you don't have Target, you got a big fucking problem, obviously. Mine didn't have it yet. I don't know what the deal is. I don't know why they don't have it yet. It's clearly an issue. I didn't like speak to a manager or anything. I wasn't going to take it that far yet. But if I go back next time, there's going to be an issue. There's going to be a fucking problem. I'm going to have to talk to someone like, yo, why didn't you guys bring in the Biscoff cookie ice cream yet? What is the delay? Oh my God, drink's so good. Jesus Christ. What was I saying? They made ice cream out of it. I want this so fucking bad. It's the greatest cookie, dude. It's so good. It's just crispy, crunchy, melts in your fucking mouth. Not chewy at all, like hard, but like in a good way. Like, That just sounded weird. A hard cookie in a good way. What the fuck am I saying? You have to have it to understand. So good. Dip in your coffee. I'm trying to find like a press release to find out when this came out. Oh shit, they have like a whole gang of flavors. The original Belgian chocolate chips, one with chocolate brownies. How many fucking flavors do they have? Salted caramel. Jesus Christ. Blueberry cheesecake. I thought there was just one. There's like six different flavors. Yo, we need this. The people need this immediately. I need this. I need this in my life. Like when I went to fucking Target a week ago, 2 weeks ago. Can we find a press release? Press release? Should we just add press release to the Google? Press release. Super premium. Again, this is from fucking June 2019. I thought this, I should have done my research first. This is not a new food item. I've just never seen it. If I had seen this in stores, I would have definitely grabbed it. Instagram, again, fucking me up, claiming that this is a new food item. If you've seen this, please let me know, because I'm willing to drive like 250 miles. Like, I would drive to fucking Ohio. That's like an 11-hour drive. How many miles is that? It's probably like 500 miles. I would drive to Ohio to go get this ice cream. I need it. Fuck. Let's go on to the next one. We got a few left. We got some goodies. Lil Debbie dropped a cereal a few months ago. Maybe like four months ago. They came out with the oatmeal pie cereal, which I have tried. Based on the popularity, I'm assuming, of the oatmeal cereal. This one right here that you're looking at. Oh, that one. Yeah. Based off of that success, they're coming out with... Oh, this is actually new. Great. February 2021. Kellogg's is releasing Cosmic Brownies cereal with Lil Debbie. I figured I would just throw it into the video. I'm not personally super excited about this. I did really like the oatmeal pie one, but for some reason this isn't like the most enticing. I don't know, it just doesn't sound just that great. I'm sure it's gonna be good, it's gonna be great, it's gonna be fucking like goated up there with the greatest cereals of all time. Maybe, probably not. $3.99 for an 8.2 ounce box, in case you wanted to know. Probably didn't. $5.69. Like, who, when they go buy cereal, does anyone like look at the fucking prices of cereal? No, because it's just like, it's cereal. Like, I look at the prices of other things, but I'm not going to be like, it's like, I know it's going to be $4. Great. Why did they even put that in this article? Do people like really need to know the pricing? Apparently. See, look at this. Fox News. They're giving you the information that like, I'm already preaching this. You learned this here on the video before you even knew, like before even Fox News told you that Lil Debbie already had a cereal. Because your boy Josh fucking hooked you up and explained that shit to you. They came out with the oatmeal pie one. Now they're coming out with the Cosmic Brownie. It's like, who wants to go to Fox News to learn that? You want to learn that shit here on the Josh Ray channel, obviously. Is it actually out yet? Oh, I just hit the mic. Can you guys hear me? Do I sound super crisp? Do I sound juicy? Are these out yet? I want to see what the fucking Delish had to say. Kellogg's releasing a Cosmic Brownie cereal in May, and it will make you feel like a kid again. I've never had Cosmic Brownies. I don't think I've ever had like the oatmeal cream pie Lil Debbie things, pastries, whatever the fuck they are. Shout out my mom for not letting me eat sugary shit. Not really. Not really shouting you out. It's more like what the fuck, mom? Like, why didn't you let me eat this shit? Because I don't even know what this is. People are probably excited about this. Probably like, holy shit, Lil Debbie, Cosmic. Oh my God, Cosmic Brownies. I don't even know what the fuck these taste like. My mom didn't let me enjoy these delicious diabetes-inducing food items. Ever wish you could bottle... This is going to be fun. Ever wish you could bottle the feeling of opening up a Cosmic Brownie from your lunchbox as a kid? No, I can't. No idea what that feeling feels like. Well, we can't exactly do that. But the next best thing is going to be available. Kellogg's announced today that it's releasing a Lil Debbie Cosmic Brownies cereal and that it will be like eating a big bowl of your favorite childhood treat. Cereal will be made with crispy, indulgent brownie squares. And of course, those little chocolate pieces will be dotted with cosmic rainbow pieces. What does that mean? Just say sprinkles. The fuck does that mean? Cosmic rainbow pieces? What? They're sprinkles. They're fucking sprinkles. Cosmic rain. Moving on. That's annoying. And again, with the pricing, at this rate, soon we'll be trading boxes of cereal like we used to trade treats in the cafeteria. Will we be doing that? I don't fucking think so. Next up, zebra cakes? Question mark? maybe. What the fuck is a zebra cake? I don't know. I didn't get to have any of this shit as a kid. Zebra cakes? Is that a thing? Are they called zebra cakes? I don't know. I've never seen this in my life. Yellow cake with cream filling covered in white icing. Oh, that does sound pretty good. And decorated with fudge strips. I need that. Next up, I see all my shit on Instagram. Like everything that we're talking about today, I find out because of Instagram, because that's like my go-to social media app. Instagram, Facebook, fuck Twitter. I can't do Twitter. I can't do it. Never been a Twitter fan, but I saw this on Instagram. Customize your Oreo. Apparently, you can go to Oreo.com and they have a new little platform called Oreo ID. Oreo by you with, we're discovering this like together simultaneously because I saw the picture on Instagram and I was like, what the fuck is that? I added it to my list and I didn't actually look into it. So we're going to explore this whole fucking weird, absurd, customized Oreo world together, you and me right now. With Oreo ID, you can customize your own Oreo cookies, gifts, and more. You can change the color of the creme. I love how they call it creme, not just cream. Like they want to be a little fancy. A little creme. Red, orange, like basically like the colors of the rainbow. And then you can put a fucking picture on it. I guess like give like a graduation gift to your daughter. Like this person right here. Like, hey, got you some custom Oreos with your face on it. That's not weird. You just eat a fucking Oreo with your own face on it. You can put sprinkles on these motherfuckers, change the image, put text. Let's make one real quick, just for shits and giggles. Let's do red, favorite color, change the dip. Oh my God, white fudge. Yeah, a little pink sprinkles, why not? Let's add an image, upload my photo. Oh boy, let's put my own face on it, shall we? Unable to locate, what? Why? What does that mean? Unable to locate. There it is, wow. This is a big day. Put my face on an Oreo. Oreo ID flavor one. You can just order one for $2.50 fucking cents. Crazy. $2.50 to get one custom Oreo? What are you going to do with it? You're going to eat it and it's going to be fucking gone? Or you put it on frame it. Put it in a frame on your wall. Why does it cost $2.50? That's probably minus shipping. Minimum order of 20. Oh, so you've ordered 20 of them. So 20 times 2. So that's like $50 to fucking dollars. What? Oh my God. I don't understand this system. Add to bag. This is too much. So yeah, you got to order 20. So you have to spend. Yeah, I'm not spending $50 on because I was never going to actually order it. But that's just fucking ridiculous. You can get 20 Oreos, which I could kill in one sitting. I could literally pull out a pack of Oreos right now, eat 20 of them. Easy. $50 down the drain. You just you might as well take like a $50 bill and just light it on fire. Nobody loves Oreos that much. We got one more item. Coup de grace. Here we go. We gotta build this one up. We gotta find this. Shaquille O'Neal has teamed up with Kellogg's and Frosted Flakes to come out with a Shaq-branded cereal. A Shaq-branded Frosted Flakes. Wait till you see his face. You gotta see his face on the box. Fucking fantastic. Should I eat this dehydrated orange on camera right now? I think I should. We gotta do it. A little ASMR crunch. Oh my God. As I was saying. Is there a commercial? I didn't realize there was a commercial. Look at this motherfucker's face. What is that face he's making? Did I do it? Did I do it right? One more time. Why is he making that face? Bro, Kellogg's, you're telling me you brought Shaq in. You had a whole photo shoot, an entire photo shoot. He's probably there for like 2 hours minimum. Y'all took hundreds of pictures. That's the one you selected to put on the box. I don't understand. It's like you could have picked so many other pictures. I can't. I don't want to go too deep on this, but the face he's making is fucking priceless. It's fantastic. This isn't going to be out, I think, for a couple months. Maybe this is just like the hype image that they're using and they're going to actually change his face on the box, but you can't put that out. Please don't put that out. I don't want to see. I feel uncomfortable just looking at what is he doing with his mouth right there? He's doing weird things with his mouth. What is this shit? They're trying to feed me an ad right now. No. Great news. Shaq and Frosted Flakes revealed a new cereal with mini cinnamon basketballs. For the first time, Frosted and Let's run it back from the top. I'm gonna get this one clean. I'm gonna get through this whole paragraph. No stuttering. No, we're gonna get through it. For the first time in Frosted Flakes history, Tony the Tiger won't be the only face smiling back at you across the breakfast table. In partnership with Kellogg's, Shaquille O'Neal will appear on boxes of the brand's Frosted Flakes with crispy cinnamon basketballs, smiling back at you. It's the best part of that sentence. He's doing something. I don't know if he's smiling. He's making some type of weird face, but. What are crispy cinnamon basketballs? What does that mean? What is that? Little basketball-shaped cereal balls, a cinnamon-flavored thing, word. I mean, it sounds like it's going to be good. I don't know why we need a check to do this. It was designed as a part of the brand's commitment to Mission Tiger, I don't know what that is, which is pledged to help 1 million kids nationwide gain better access to sports by the end of the by the end of 2021. Okay, so there we go. Now it makes sense to me. Yeah, you could have done it without Shaq, but there's like a greater purpose to it. It's not just, let's just throw Shaq on there because it's Shaq. It's like, there's a whole reason behind it. That's kind of beautiful. Okay. As of February 17th, the initiative has provided sports equipment and donations. So almost 500,000 kids at schools where sports programs have been cut. Beautiful. So when is it coming out? That's the real question. That's what we need to know. Release date. Can we get a fucking release date, Shaq? Seriously. What are we doing right now? Kazam! What is this saying? I don't know what I'm reading right now. All right. It doesn't look like we have a release date. I could have sworn I read something. Okay, yeah. We'll be out in April. According to Junk Food On The Go via Instagram. That's their handle. Apparently, they have the inside scoop that Google somehow doesn't have. But this cereal is coming out in April, according to them. Don't take my word for it. So if it doesn't come out in April, you can blame Junk Food On The Go. That's exciting. I'm super big on cereal, probably because another thing my mother didn't let me do, she didn't let me get any cereal over 10. There was a limit. It was like, if I was going to pick a cereal in the cereal aisle, it had to be 10 grams of sugar or under. Therefore, like all the fucking good ones, Lucky Charms, Golden Grahams, fucking Frosted Flakes, Fruit Loops, like Trix, like all of them, all the bad shit, all the good, bad shit, I wasn't allowed to have. So now I just like gorge myself on cereal. I have an obsession with fucking cereal. It's like the greatest fucking, not the greatest food ever, but it's like the greatest food category items. Fucking crunchy, filling, sugary, sweet, delicious. Like, ugh, I love cereal. So I'm pretty hyped on that one. I'm probably out of this entire list of shit we just went through. That's probably the only thing I'm actually going to go out and seek and try and buy. The question is, will it be good? We're going to have to wait and find out. A little sneak peek for next week. Ugh. Can't wait. That is the episode, the show, the segment, the whatever the fuck this is for today, for this week. 1000% be back next week for another little food roundup, food and drink news roundup of sorts. And by then, hopefully you will have helped me selected a name for the show. So in the comments, drop one right now. What do you think we should call this? I don't want to just do like foodie news or food and drink news. I want to come with something a little bit more creative with that. So drop a comment. Let me know what you think it should be, the name of the show. If you enjoyed, please, by all means, you see where I'm pointing right there? There is a like button. Take your mouse, take your little finger, wherever you're watching this, scroll down to the like button and just hit that like button. You know what I'm saying? Hit the subscribe button if you want to see more videos. Food reviews, beer reviews, food and drink news. We're doing all of it. Again, this is your one-stop shop. Like, there's no one else fucking doing it. And if they are, no one's doing it like me. I'll see y'all next week. I fucking love you. I'm out of here.